What if I told you that we do imaging wrong, at least for doing tasks? This is not a camera. That's a camera. And that's an important difference. See, what you're looking at here is a biology-inspired visual sensor, and it offers a whole new way to approach imaging. I'm Greg Cohen, an associate professor from the International Center for Neuromorphic Systems at Western Sydney University. I'm the algorithms lead for a research group with over 20 academics, ranging from silicon chip designers to neuroscientists. And we design, build, and apply neuromorphic sensors like these. Sensors that work in a completely different way to conventional cameras. The pixels in these cameras are independent and asynchronous, generating data only in response to local changes in light. This means that there are no frames, no exposure times, no saturation effects, and no motion blur. Take one of these sensors and point at a static scene and you'll get no data. Only when something moves to the activated pixel send you information. Compare this to a conventional camera where we pull frames out at a fixed rate, regardless of what's going on in the scene. By contrast, these cameras push data to us only when something happens. And if we build our processing in the same way, in this event-based way, then we only need to process when something happens, saving computation, bandwidth, and most importantly, power. And we aim to bring the computation and the sensing as close together as possible into the silicon. This gives us specialized imaging sensors that are built to do their task and only capture the information needed to do that. This makes these cameras energy efficient and low bandwidth, making them perfect for space applications. They also overcome lots of the problems with conventional cameras because, like our eyes, they can work across a wide range of illumination. Take the example of docking a spacecraft, where you can have a bright background and a dark foreground, or vice versa. Normal cameras saturate, ours don't. Integrating the processing into the sensing system allows us to use the movement of the sensor to sense even better. For example, we can track satellites and map the star field behind them in real time, do high-speed detection and classification tasks, and even see through obstructions like clouds and bushes. Applying this technology to visual tasks that are well-defined will get us closer to the power efficiency, the adaptability, and the robustness of biological systems. And we are already doing that. We build and operate mobile containerized observatories that use these cameras to become tolerant to motion. And we, in collaboration with the United States Air Force Academy, have a confirmed spot in the International Space Station for two of these sensors next year to study atmospheric phenomena. This will be the first time neuromorphic sensors will be used in space, providing us with space heritage for our sensors. Over the last 2 years, we have received over $10 million in fundamental research funding for the science behind this technology. We've retained all the intellectual property, and now we're looking to commercialize our research. This is our future for imaging, and it's here now.